No statue for me, I see.
The statues are for the dead. And I always hoped you were not among them.
Wow. So, not entirely right about it being a quest, unless all of a sudden we're going to go to Saladin and he's going to give us something, but there's Efrideet. Not among the dead at all. Something I'm very glad about. That gives us a nice little introduction to her, even if it is just a little cutscene. Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here. I'm going to go ahead and give you guys the review of the Iron Banner inventory that you're all used to, but this time, of course, with that cutscene, it's a little bit special. I am doing this live, as I always do, so excuse me if the loading time here is a little bit long. Just dropping in now as I hear things, and fingers crossed. I do believe, by the way, that we're going to have the doors to Vostok Observatory open for when this happens. So, yeah, we shall see if that's the case. I can already hear Efrideet talking, because it gives you a little bit of a displacement factor when you first log in. You've basically got all of the voices in close proximity. So, yeah. And there we go. Alright, let's report to Saladin first, see what happens. Seeing as that's where Bungie told us to go at the very beginning, report to Saladin. Let's see what he's got to say.
The Iron Banner returns, but this time, another will guide you in my place. Lady Efrideet. When last we parted centuries ago, I thought I would never see her again. But I will let her tell you that story.
So it is a new quest! Ah, called it! Find the new Iron Banner vendor, also Dusty Iron Engram. Keep in mind this is for Silver Dust. Iron Engrams can be used, if I'm not mistaken, to acquire old items from years 1 and 2. Let's go ahead and just decrypt a few of these, just as an example. So, it's Tyra Khan, as usual. Iron Regalia Hood, Iron Breed Gloves, and Iron Breed Boots. Now these are all old Iron Banner items. All of them dropping at 3 light. So for example, these Iron Breed Gloves, I had a set of these. In fact, I still have a set of these in my vault. And these look gorgeous. I mean, look at that. Wonderful little design on there. But you can also now get these, of course, with all the shader enhancements of Year 3. And you can bump them up to Year 3 light levels. Now, of course, because all of these are dropping at 3 light, they're going to be at the kind of, well, interesting stage where you can't exactly tell what roles they're going to have, whether it's going to be a decent one or not. So these, in terms of infusion, are going to be a little bit tricky to manage. But still, if you want a really old piece of armor from the Iron Banner, you can potentially get it through these Dusty Iron Engrams. They do cost 5 silver dust, though, so that's something which you're going to have to go to Eververse for, sadly. Or alternatively, you're going to have to go ahead and dismantle one of your Eververse treasure boxes' contents for. Not great, but eh, something, though. For collectors like me, I know that this is something I'm vaguely excited for. I can go ahead and finally spec into the old armor that I loved from so many years ago. Anyway, enough of my decryptions. Let's go ahead and check with Tyra Khan. I do believe that she is going to be... Yep, you can see over there. Doors to the Iron Temple are indeed open. So she will be out there. And I was correct again. Oh, look over there. Over by the observatory. I'm not entirely sure what the apparatus is. But over by this building. Here. Exactly where I predicted it would be. Oh my god, I'm so happy I'm right. I can't believe I'm correct. It's not exactly on this thing, where I was talking about it being, but pretty damn close. And look at that, the new Iron Banner risen again. Lady Efrideet in all her splendor. So let's talk.
You must be the one Saladin spoke of. My name's Efrideet. I served with the Iron Lords a long time ago, and I have returned to serve again.
I am Efrideet. Once I was an Iron Lord, then, after many years of searching, I found other ways to serve the Light. Now I have returned to fulfill the oath I made long ago. You are here to complete... You're here to compete, rather, in the Iron Banner, yes? Light is the most powerful weapon in a Guardian's arsenal, and there is no better place to hone it than the Iron Banner.
Trust your Light and trust yourself.
Reach rank 1 of Iron Banner. So it's an actual Iron Banner quest. You can go through and complete each part of it, and yeah. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at the inventory. So first of all, the bounties. These are brand new bounties. Each of these is going to go ahead and award you not just legendary marks like it always used to, and not just Iron Banner standing, but now all of these award you a piece of gear. So you can see with this one, the Iron Marathon, which is complete 5 matches, win 10 matches. Oh wait, no, sorry, I'm reading that wrong. Earn 100 points by playing in the Iron Banner, match completions are worth 5 and match wins are worth 10. Then yeah, you can go ahead and actually get an Iron Banner weapon from this. And this is going to be something that drops outside of the inventory. So if you see a weapon here, it's not going to be the shotgun or the auto rifle. We'll get to these in a minute. I'm excited to see whether these have decent rolls or not. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and pick up all of these. So yeah. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at these. This is exciting, actually, because this right here, as far as I'm seeing, a lot of these are very high-quality rolls. Already, there's some great stuff to look out for. So, first of all, let's take a look at the gloves here. Got 2 sets for every class, I'm going to presume. These Warlock ones, at least, this is a 98% to 98 to 100% roll stat, I believe. 41-41, I believe, is as good as it gets. The gloves that I currently have equipped, the new Monarchy ones here, these, I believe, are... yeah. These are just at 96-98. So these gloves are as good as it gets in terms of stat rolls. Like, pick these up. And keep in mind that stat rolls do max out at 350, so there's no way these are going to get better, but already, if you see one of these pairs of gloves that you like, pick it up. I know that personally I'm looking at this one. This is going to be a great set to use with the Mida. Scout Rifle Loader, Snap Discharge for the extra melee attack speed, Intellect and Discipline. This, I'm picking this up, there's no question about that. Next, let's go ahead and look at the bonds. Same case in terms of stats. Intellect Discipline Bond, this is a perfect roll. This is 100% of the roll. And my god, does that look pretty. And again, you know, the stats don't really matter too much beyond the intellect or discipline gains, but again, well worth picking up just for the stats if you're interested in min-maxing to a tier 12 build. So yeah, pretty good. This one is a little unfortunate because it is a 96%. The strength stat here is a little bit lackluster, but you know, bonds, cloaks, whatever you have is not too hard to come across. So as far as I can see for the Warlock at least, very good sets of gear here. Let's take a look at the shotgun next. The Proud Spire, forged in honor of Silamar. He who... oh my god, is that a graph? Is that a... are you guys seeing this too? Is that a graphical error or am I just going mad? Let's try and reload that. I'm going to assume that's a graphical error because this is way brighter than it should look. Anyway, let's go ahead and take a look at the rolls on this. We have... and by the way, this is an invective type, except it does not have the range of invective. It is one of the lower impact, high rate of fire ones, and immediately for PvP, that's nowhere near as good as some of the others. It is not going to compete with the Matador. However, sometimes there are good rolls that you can get on these for PvE. This might actually have one. So, let's go ahead and take a look. We've got Oiled Frame here, we've got Casket Mag, and we've got Replenish. That, I think, is going to be your ideal PvE roll, because you're going to get 7 in the mag here. Oiled Frame means you're going to have the fast reloads, but let's say that you really want to go up and do some damage, and let's say you're something like a Striker or a Defender Titan, maybe you're just a Sunsinger with self-res, maybe you've got Storm Trance. Go ahead and empty your entire magazine into a group of targets, and then pop your super. Replenish 7 rounds with Casket Mag. There's some great synergy there, I think. The rest of it, yeah, I guess you can use this roll to do something decent in PvP, but... the range on this is going to be nowhere near as good as something like, say, the Matador, and it does not have Smooth Ballistics, which is the highest range upgrade as far as I'm aware. So, this is not an ideal PvP shotgun. In PvE, though, this might be worth picking up just because of the speed of this weapon. I'd also need to see what the inventory of a weapon like this is like, but, eh, we can't see that right now. Now, the Auto Rifle, which I think is a little bit more promising immediately. So... I see we have perfect balance on here at least. This, by the way, is of course going to be a Doctrine of Passing archetype weapon. You've got very low impact, very high rate of fire. So this thing is going to be a bit of a hard one to control. You've got unique sights here as well. I have no idea what any of these look like, although I'd assume that they're similar to the ones that you can get from the weapons you can acquire in the Archon's Forge. And yeah, let's see, reinforced barrel for the extra range, but honestly with a weapon like this I think you need stability. Hipfire and Hidden Hand, eh, hipfire is an okay bonus, I think Hidden Hand is the better of the two. And with Casket Mag, I suppose if you are going to use a bullet hose weapon, this is going to have a massive magazine, but really I don't see many ideal perks here. This is not going to be really any challenge to the Doctrine of Passing. So sadly, this one's a bit of a bust. As for using it in PvE, maybe you can use it, but an auto rifle of this archetype, you really do still need high stability no matter what game mode you use it in. That's a bit unfortunate, really. I was looking forward to this weapon. It's a bit of a bust. Either way, never mind. Maybe next time. There's still a lot of other Iron Banner weapons for us to go ahead and experiment with. But in the meantime, I'm going to go ahead and let you guys go out there and play for it. There is indeed an Iron Banner quest. There is indeed a cutscene that comes with it. Efrideet in all her glory has returned to us. And I don't know about you guys, but I look forward to playing the Iron Banner some more. This is going to be a fresh experience, and I feel as though, even though it's going to be sweaty, sweaty as always, I'm going to look forward to getting up some new gear. In the meantime though, guys, my name is Bife. Prodacia Arastra. I'll see you, Starside.